Hey YouTube, it's Amy and Ben here to chat again.
Hey.
We're from Lounge Room Empire, where we're conquering the world one armchair at a time, including India.
Yeah, so we're doing something a little bit different today in that we are reviewing or giving our immediate reaction to a trailer for an Indian film. I'm not sure if you classify it as a Bollywood film. I'm not sure if that's distinct in terms of the films that include Indian dancing or just more broadly that are produced in India. But this one is a little bit different, and it's different in terms of what we're seeing, but also for us, because this is largely in Hindi. There are a couple of lines that are in English, so we're largely reviewing this based on the
visual
spectacle from which we've observed.
And I think if this is something that we enjoy doing, then we might be learning stuff about Bollywood and what the differences are for movie genres that seem to really hit it big for Indian audiences.
Yeah, and so the thing to remember with this, and part of our consideration doing this, is that although there aren't a lot of places outside of India that speak Hindi, there are 1 billion people. This is a huge market.
Yeah.
And it's a market where there is a lot of investment and a lot of growth. And you can see that in terms of the films that you see that they've been producing from 5 years ago to now, let alone like 10 years ago or 15 years ago.
I want to see what all the fuss is about.
Yeah.
So I have seen what all the fuss is about.
Yeah, Saho. For this one, Saho. This trailer has everything.
It has it all.
I'm both being facetious but also truthful in that this is James Bond meets Fast and Furious meets some type of romance story.
A sci-fi.
There were some fantasy elements in there, which they're kind of
magical
diving.
Realism.
Yeah, they're like diving through the clouds or something like that. There's, you know, the love story, and then, you know, it appears that the partner is killed and he goes on revenge. There's some Transformers in there.
Yeah.
It just bloody has everything.
It's everything, and it's on such a huge, fantastical level that almost to my mind, I'm like, is there a difference between audiences that are used to this type of movie? Because I was like assaulted in a good way, but felt my eyes felt assaulted by the filtering on it. It's very sharp to the point of like over sharp.
Well, yeah, it's very fantastical.
Yeah, so but it, I just mean the filter itself seemed to be really.
Yeah, well, on that, I felt like there was that fantasy element where it's not, I'm not sure, I don't know the history of this film. I don't know if it's part of a franchise or if it's new or if this director has a specific style. But that filtering and the graphics, it actually felt like it was intentionally not meant to be completely real in terms of the CGI, but beyond real. Mm. So it was really like, you know, when things were swinging around, they were too sharp or those colors were too bright.
Or the semi-trailer that's suddenly falling down from the sky on this guy is too large.
Yeah, it's too, and it just, there just aren't semi-trailers like that. It looked like it was, you know, Optimus Prime about to kind of transform.
Yeah, and it could be.
So I thought that this was a really good wading into the pool of Indian cinema.
Yeah.
And I think it's going to be a good journey for us to learn about how these films are put together, what they are, and what the differences are to a largely Western cinematic experience, which we're used to.
Yeah, a few things I'd like to point out in terms of conceptual elements that are slightly different from what I'm used to.
Yeah.
And also, I was kind of looking at the actors and the characters to see what is it that attracts people in the audience to these types of people. What is it that's different from what we would normally be attracted to in characters? Certainly, I feel like the main character, he's a very cool, suave, spy-type James Bond guy. Yep. James Bond, Daniel Craig version or something similar, I suppose, would have it a little bit tempered down. So what I noticed, a bit weird, he had those aviators.
Reflective
glasses. So I'm like, so you're a dude who's meant to be going undercover, but you've somehow got the most shiny glasses that are clearly going to make you stand out. Very glamorous.
And that's what reminded me of the Fast and Furious piece. So that's what, where it's like, you know, a bit more blingy and glammy.
Which to me is something that seems to happen in that society and something that they prize.
Maybe it's more of a status symbol.
Yeah. It's just, I find it interesting that, like, they're okay to have that really bright stuff. And they're also okay to have really jarring, distinct changes in tone.
And pace.
So in tone, I found it really interesting that you have music that's clearly indicating it is a Fast and the Furious type car chase. Then it suddenly turns into major Michael Bay style explosions.
Yeah.
Then you see the falling down of a building.
Then they're on a yacht. Then they're on a yacht in a
it's a pink lake.
Yeah.
It's fuchsia, magenta.
And surrounded by pelicans.
Yeah, and they just have this like amazing love story that we're suddenly swept along with, and it's not so much seeming to deal with the subtleties of that love story, but more that these people are elevated to the status of love.
The passion around
and the romance of love, and then she, of course, is going to get slaughtered. She doesn't just die in a normal way, but all you see is her body just kind of being dragged, covered in blood. So she hasn't met a glorious end.
I really hope she's not dead there. I would hope that you would kind of respect the body of your partner a bit more than kind of just dragging her dead by the arm.
He's probably wanting to take her someplace to like allow sort of burial rites of some description, but it was so jarring to me to have this sudden beautiful Bollywood style romance music, and then suddenly it's like boom, and I was like, whoa, assaulted.
And then he's like locked up in a room, and out of the darkness you see the glowing eyes of what appears to be a freaking panther.
Yeah, so of course there's a panther involved. This is another sign of glamour.
This is just, it just has everything. I am very, I actually want to see this.
Yeah.
And I really want to track down, I haven't done too much research. I want to track down a trailer version that has English subtitles, because I want to know more about what's going on.
Yeah, I would be interested to like watch it and then go and say, okay, how different is this from another movie? How many of these movies are coming out like this?
Yeah.
Is there actual storylines? Are there actual plot pieces that make sense to what we understand movie completely experiences to be? Or is it an entirely new universe that we've just opened ourselves up to? And like a magpie drawn to shiny things, are we going to find the rest of cinema dull in comparison?
Yeah, it was definitely a feast for the senses and a really positive experience. I think coming away from it, this being our first one that we've probably watched it with a serious critical eye, but also, exploring it as something that we can spend more time in. I found a really positive experience. I'm not sure if this is how all the films are. This one might be a rarity and might be more to do with the production company that has a reputation for doing this, or the director.
Yeah, I know there was a one-named person, Madonna, like done by Madonna, by Lady Gaga, by...
Yeah, and it was quite prominent too, so I don't know.
The artist, formerly known as Prince.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But I found it really positive. I'm actually kind of looking forward to learning about this a lot more.
Yeah. So let us know if you guys have a bit of insight or any direction that we can take with these types of movies, or whether you've got some personal joys and movies that you love.
Yeah, let us know your thoughts. But even on this trailer, what did you think of it? Particularly if you are a fan or someone quite experienced in Bollywood. Yeah, in Bollywood or in Indian cinema. Mm-hmm. Let us know in the comments below. While you're there, hit like.
Hit subscribe.
And we will see you next time.
See ya.